Hello everyone, welcome to a new video of Indicator Store. On today's video, we are presenting the new release of the system Marker Plus for NinjaTrader 8. This is the March release of 2020. And we have several new features and also a lot of new improvements on the speed of processment of the charts. Something that we notice with the current high volatility, when we have a lot of signals on the chart, it was very visible that the refreshing of a chart took too much time. So when we reload the chart, it takes a lot of time, and sometimes it was not enough to paint some of the panels. The number of candles, the number of bars, is much higher than usual because the high volatility makes those charts where they are not minute bars, like for example range, ticks, Unirenko, then we have a lot of more bars per minute. So it takes a lot of more processor time to create a chart. But we decrease the time to compute. And for example, on this chart, I am using the end indicator to paint. Here we can see the conditions. When the HMA has an uptrend, after having a downtrend, so it is changing the direction. But it only paints those signals when they are aligned with the slope of the linear regression. So this is the HMA crossover filtered by the linear regression. So if we have a chart with a lot of signals and takes a lot of time to compute, some of the panels may get blank, so we only get the real-time data. So the chart keeps working only with real-time, but the historical is not shown. Anyway, now we can extend the time to calculate. 15,000 is 15 seconds, because this is in milliseconds. So we can increase that number if the computer is not fast enough to compute, or if I am not interested in the historical, I can decrease this to 500, half second. So it makes it creates the chart faster, but without some of the historical results. Anyway, it keeps working, because the real time is also always working. And something new on the strategy when we apply Marker Plus, now we have the option when we are not entering at market. We are using limit or stop orders. Let's say this arrow is my entry, either because I am looking for the object or the fast signal, because the indicator, the end indicator, is creating both the blue arrow and also the fast signal. But when I have a signal, if instead of entering at market, I want to enter with a limit order, for example, 2 ticks from the low of the candle, then we need that reference. We use it to select the low as reference. And now we have also the close and the open of the signal bar. So now this is the reference. But only before, it was only of the signal bar. The reference was the signal bar. And on some setups, we were interested in a few bars bug. So on those cases, we can change this number. One is the bar with the signal. The low of two bars back, then we can change this number to 3. And this offset is, as usual, if it is positive, then it improves the entry price. So for a long, if we are using the low of this bar, 3 bars back, then we improve that price by 4 ticks. So we place a buy limit at this place. And it waits for the following 4 bars. After that number of bars, if the order don't get a fill, then it is canceled. As usual, the offset can also be negative. So instead of improving the entry price, we make it worse. For example, if this is the reference, then we go to the upside. That will be a buy stop entry. And this is for the reference when we use non-market orders. Another new feature, as we saw, all the variables are global per instrument. For example, let's say this instrument is the Mini YM, Mini Dow Jones, also this one. And at the bottom we have the normal Dow Jones. So let's say we copy a line. So we use a marker copy, select a name, for example, EMA34 or whatever. And on input series, we set which is the instrument and parameters that we want to copy. On this case, an EMA34. And when we click on OK, then it paints the copied line. This variable, EMA100 or whatever I want to use, for example, my EMA, this variable is global, so it is available on all charts with the same instrument. For example, I can use it on this other chart. I can create a logic or paint the line. For example, I can use markers paint, type the variable name, my EMA, and when I click on OK, it just paints the same line that copied on the other chart. But what happens on this other chart? This is the main Dow Jones, not the same instrument. If I do this on this chart, it is not going to paint anything because the variable my EMA only exists on the Mini Dow Jones. So between charts of the same instrument, all the variables are global, and we can also create a logic from lines copied from another chart. For example, let's say I want to use the end indicator to calculate when the low of the bar is greater than the blue line, the EMA, my EMA. So when I click on OK, let's name it result. The histogram at the bottom has this name, result. And what we see here on this histogram, the result of the end indicator has only two options. Blue is true, plus one, and red is false, minus one. And we can see that it is true when the bars are over the line, not touching it. While the price is over the line, the result at the bottom is true. And don't forget that this line is not from this chart. It was copied from the other chart. Now, on any of these indicators, we can also create MAT expressions. For example, I can subtract 10 points. So I paint the line, shifted 10 points to the downside. We can see, but the logic at the bottom is still looking at my EMA, not at my EMA shifted 10 points. But anyway, I can change also that logic inside the conditions and say that the low of the current bar is bigger, greater than my EMA minus 10 points. And then the result, the histogram result at the bottom corresponds to the line that we get painted. We can see here the formula is when low zero, the current bar, is bigger than my EMA minus 10. And my EMA is the line copied on the left chart. Now, let's see if I copy one of these lines. I have the option to create a general global variable. I only need to add this on the name. Let's say I copy this linear regression, the black line. So it is a linear regression of 100. So I can copy. On input series, I place the indicator, linear regression. Of 100. But on the name, instead of just placing a standard name, I add this symbol in front. The same symbol that uses NinjaTrader for drawing objects. That means that this variable is global between all instruments. Now we can see that we have the linear regression and overlapped the copied version. We can move one line to the bottom. The blue line is the copy, the black line is the original. And now this copy is global, so I can paste it on, I can paint it on the mini. I can paint it everywhere, but it has more sense using on an instrument with the same value, like for example using between the main instrument and the mini instrument. So I can use the paint indicator and type the name with the same symbol in front. We can see here is the name linear regression. So now we get the linear regression painted over the price. So here we can see that we have it on real time. On this chart we have on blue is the copy, the real in real time, on black is the original line. It is at bar close. The real time is so now let's remove everything and watch something else. Something that we can also do is using the signals. On this setup, paint signals each time the red line and HMA changes the slope, but only when it is in agreement with the slope of the black line. That, as we can see, it has not painted the historical because we decreased the time to compute. But anyway, it is working because on real time it always works. But it is creating a fast signal. Now, what happens if on the fast signal I type the same symbol to make it global? That means that we can make it fire on another instrument, for example, on the mini. Here I place a markers, configure to trade fast signals, and reading the fast signals created by the other instrument at the bottom. Go long and go short. And those signals can be created from another chart, another instrument, or even from two different charts at the same time, because we can have several setups, all of them using the same signal. So one chart is trading one setup, another chart is trading another setup, and the signals are read by these markers and executing the signals coming from different places. So if I enable, now when I get the signal painted on Dow Jones, on the main Dow Jones, then it should execute the same order on the mini. So we need the red line to change the direction, but the following signal is not going to fire nothing because the black line is trending up. So we need the red line going down and then back up again. So now we have a short sig trending down, but not painted because the black line is going to the upside. So let's wait for a signal in agreement. This long is not executed, not painted, because the black line is sloping down. Here we can see the conditions. And there we have a short. The red line started to trend down, and the black line is also trending down. And we can see that it fired an order on the mini. So on the following videos, I will show more details of each one of the indicators. Hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question or comment, please post below. Thank you. Bye bye.